As we have seen in the previous lecture, according to the nature of information bearing signal, the communication can be divided into analog communication system and digital communication system. Now let's understand what is analog and digital communication system. Analog communication system. In this communication system, the data is transferred in between the transmitter and the receiver with the help of an analog signal. Now, what is an analog signal? Before understanding the analog signal, we need to understand what is analog data. Data are entities that convey meaning or information, like computer file, music on CD, speech, and regular clock. Signals are the electric or electromagnetic encoding of data. When the data is analog or data is available for every instant of time, we can represent this data by an analog signal like speech or clock. This analog or continuous signal is used for analog communication system. Analog signal is a continuous signal. The value of the analog signal varies continuously with the time. The value range of the analog signal cannot be fixed. The behavior of an analog signal can be described with the help of three parameters: amplitude, phase, and frequency. Some characteristics of the analog signal can be given by: analog signals are continuous in nature. The value of the analog signal can either be positive or negative. The security of the analog signal is not encrypted or coded. The bandwidth or the data transfer rate of the analog signal is low. Transmission medium can either be wired or wireless. Data transmission using the analog signal is slow compared to the digital signal. As the data transmission is slow, the analog signal consumes more power than the digital signal. The impedance of analog signal is low, that's why it gets distorted by noise during the transmission. The data storage of an analog signal is in the form of wave, and it broadcasts the information in the form of wave. Analog signals are portable and low cost. A real-life example of the analog signal is the representation of human voice, as this voice signal varies continuously with the time. One of the standard form of analog signal is a sinusoidal signal. Sinusoidal signal is said to be continuous time-varying signal because during its time period, the value of the signal is available for every instant of time, and also it varies continuously with the time. If we look at the sinusoidal signal, then we can see that it has certain amplitude, phase, and frequency. So the behavior of this signal can be described with respect to these three parameters. As we can see, the sinusoidal signal is changing from positive maximum value to negative maximum value, and then again going to the positive value. So this analog signal can have both positive and negative values. These types of signals are used in the analog communication system. So analog communication system is the method of conveying voice, image signal, video information using a continuous signal which varies in amplitude, phase, and other property in proportion to that of the variable or the information bearing signal. The block diagram for this type of communication is same as the block diagram for the communication system which we have discussed in the previous lecture. If you haven't watched it, then go to the analog communication playlist and watch the lecture on the basic block diagram of the communication system. In the analog communication system, instead of using any kind of information bearing signal, analog signal is used. At first, this analog signal is converted to electrical signal or message signal. Then it is passed through this communication channel. The transfer of this analog signal through the communication channel can be done by using analog modulation methods or no modulation at all. Modulation is performed in the transmitter section, and the demodulation to the corresponding modulated signal is performed in the receiver section to demodulate the signal. Modulations and demodulations performed in the analog communication can be classified into amplitude modulation or demodulation, frequency modulation or demodulation, and phase modulation or demodulation. Detailed explanation of this modulation or demodulation techniques will be given in the incoming lectures. Now, let's see what is digital communication system. Digital communication system. In this communication system, the digital signal is used for the communication between source and destination. Digital communication system is almost same as the analog communication system. Only difference between these two communication system is, instead of using analog signal, it uses a digital signal for communication. First, we need to understand how to get the digital signal from analog data. Although we can give analog data in the computer, but it can never store analog data as it requires a huge memory. Computer converts this analog data to digital data with the help of ADC or analog to digital converter. During this conversion, image is split into pixels, Video can be splitted into frames. Audio can be splitted into samples in order to store them in the computers in the digital format. So the information available in the computer is in the digital data format. This digital data is converted to digital signal with the help of encoding systems. Encoding system can be classified as line encoding, block encoding, and scrambling. Block encoding and scrambling may not be needed, but the line encoding is always needed. So what is the digital signal? A digital signal consists of discrete values rather than continuous value. A digital signal signifies a discrete signal that carries the binary data in the form of 0 and 1. Now, when we are using line coding schemes to represent the digital data in the form of digital signal, then we can apply two different methods, namely unipolar and polar line encoding schemes. When we consider unipolar line encoding schemes to represent the digital data, then the digital signal stays on the x-axis or above the x-axis. And when we consider the polar line encoding, then the digital signal is available on the both sides of the x-axis. Here, unipolar line encoding is used to represent the digital data 100, 1011. Digital signals describes the behavior of the signal with respect to the bit rate as well as the bit interval. Bit rate is the number of bits that are conveyed or processed per unit of time, and the signal processes 7 bits per second, so the bit rate is 7 bps. The bit interval is the time required to transmit one single bit. Here, 1 second is required to transmit 7 bits, so the bit interval for this signal is 1 by 7 seconds. Some characteristics of the digital signal. Digital signals are discrete. Digital signal is limited as well as ranges from 0 to 1. A digital signal is either positive or 0. A digital signal is encrypted or coded. The bandwidth or maximum data transmission rate of the digital signal is high. Transmission medium for the digital signal must be weird. The data transmission using the digital signal is faster compared to the analog signal. As the data transmission rate is fast, the digital signal consumes less power than the analog signal. A digital signal has resistance in response toward the noise. Therefore, it does not often face distortion or has greater noise immunity. A digital signal broadcasts the information in the form of binary data. Digital signals are portable, similar to computers, and they are expensive. The example of the digital signal is the digital clock or data transmission in a computer. A standard example of the digital signal is square wave. Square wave is consist of higher and lower value represented by 1 and 0. For the half of the time period, the value of the signal is 1, and for the other half, the value of the signal is 0. The block diagram for this type of communication is same as the basic block diagram for the communication system. In the digital communication system, instead of using any kind of information bearing signal, a digital signal is being used. In the digital communication system, the transfer of data occurs in the form of digital bit stream over point-to-point or point-to-multipoint transmission medium. Point-to-point communication means the channel is shared between two devices or nodes. As you can see, in this point-to-point communication system, the channel is shared between two stations. Multipoint communication means that the channel is shared among multiple devices or nodes. As you can see, in this multipoint communication system, the channel is shared between three stations. The data is often represented as an electromagnetic signal, such as an electrical voltage signal or an infrared signal. Similar to analog communication, the modulation is performed in the transmitter section and demodulation to the corresponding modulation is performed in the receiver section. The modulations and demodulations in the digital communication can be classified into amplitude shift keying modulation or demodulation, frequency shift keying modulation or demodulation, and phase shift keying modulation or demodulation. These modulation and demodulation techniques will be discussed in length in the lecture series of the digital communication, but I will try to give a short discussion in this modulation and demodulation techniques in the lecture of passband and baseband transmission. Let's see the comparison between analog and digital communication system. In the first column, we have basis of comparison. In the second column, we have analog communication system. And in the third column, we have digital communication system. Type of signal used. Type of the signal used in the analog communication system is analog signal, and the type of the signal used in the digital communication system is digital signal. The amplitude of the signal being used. The amplitude of the signal varies continuously from 0 to 100 in the analog communication system and amplitude of the signal is of two levels, where low is represented by 0 and high is represented by 1 in the digital communication system. Noise immunity. In the analog communication system, the signal gets affected by the noise during the transmission through the communication channel. In the digital communication system, the signal gets less affected by the noise during the transmission through the communication channel. Broadcasting capability. In the analog communication system, broadcasting is possible to limited number of channels. In the digital communication system, broadcasting is possible to large number of channels. Error probability. Error probability in the analog communication system is high. Error probability in the digital communication system is low. Noise immunity. Noise immunity in the analog communication system is low. Noise immunity in the digital communication system is high. Encryption or coding. Encryption is not possible in the analog communication system. Encryption is possible in the digital communication system. Type of multiplexer. Analog communication system uses frequency division multiplexing and digital communication system uses time division multiplexing. System cost. System cost for the analog communication system is low, and for the digital communication system, system cost is high. Power consumption. The power consumption of the analog communication system is high, and the power consumption for the digital communication system is low. Bandwidth. Analog communication system has low bandwidth, and the digital communication system has high bandwidth. Synchronization. Synchronization is complex in the analog communication system. Compared to the analog communication system, synchronization is very easy in the digital communication system. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.